the time of Abbasid Empire and Harun al-Rashid at Baghdad, they set up an empire. That empire specialized on education. And they have a place called the House of Wisdom. House of Wisdom, only those intellectuals back in the days, that was like 8th century, 9th century, intellectuals come here and debate. Somebody will sit down on the table for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, up to 1 hour, not saying anything, just thinking of something. So they call that place the House of Wisdom. At that time, guess what? The Europeans were living in caves. They don't take no shower. On culture, when the information technology is coming from the Arabian Peninsula, precisely the Quran, the Messenger Muhammad, someone advised Muslim follower, go seek knowledge as far as you can. Some say as far as China. Some say this hadith is da'if. Believe or not, when the Messenger passed away, some of the Sahaba decided to go to China. Why is it that the Messenger said, go seek knowledge even as far as China? So they want to go to China because if you look at the map at that time, Mongolia is further off, it's much further than China. But why didn't he mention Mongolia? He was talking about the relative distance, the, you know, how far that it is. He could have mentioned Mongolia. So there was a debate among, you know, the Sahaba. So some of them left to go to China and see. And the first thing they saw in the marketplace was paper. This paper that you write on. That was the first thing they saw, and they were baffled because at that time they needed a long-lasting quality material to present the Quran on it. So then going to China, they began to establish business between the Muslims and the known world at that time. Because they write on shoulder blade of an animal, material that is low lasting quality. So when they saw the paper, they became broken between the Chinese and the world of life. They brought a lot of paper to Spain when the Muslims were ruling Spain for over 800 years. So you see what knowledge can do. Knowledge is very, very powerful, it's very important. In Islam or in the Quran, you know very well that I know, that you know, that the information about seeking knowledge is so much so that the first revelation Allah mentioned knowledge. Today, the world that we live in, it is all about knowledge. See what I'm doing right now? I speak to people from far, if you hear me, it's all about knowledge. Mankind have put his hand on all the leaders that there is on the face of the earth just to acquire knowledge. You tell me that if you think education is what? It's expensive, try ignorance. Yeah, that's true. With your master's degree, sometimes it's difficult to get a job. You might not even go to school at all. That would be terrible. So education is actually a powerful something that we have to garnish as long as we live in this part of the world. The Arabic language used to be the lingua franca of the world at the time when the Europeans were living in cages. The Muslims were bombarded with information technology. You've got to speak Arabic language to be able to understand what is going on at that time. Knowledge in the Islamic world was so ferocious and powerful that the pages of history bear record to the fact that Muslims were there from the beginning. So the Europeans owe the Muslims an incalculable debt in terms of knowledge. The Europeans wish today that they can somehow erase the contribution of Islam in terms of knowledge. But it has gone down to the annals of history. You can't do otherwise. You can't do otherwise. And I was watching a television back in the States some years ago. I was just sitting down, you know, just wandering around, living room, I turned the TV on. And I saw this Caucasian, it's a white guy with blonde hair, blue eyes. And among his titles, his degree, this and that, and in bracket they say he's a specialist on the Fulani tribe. And I was saying that I am Fulani. He's like, what's going on, man? He's a white guy, specialist on my language, in my tribe, and he never been to my village. What is going on? So then we do play me. See, we refuse to read, even though Allah asks us to read. So they write about us. Most of the books today, book the library, is them writing. You have Professor James Bokman, who wrote something about Islam and the Sira. I don't understand. It's because we don't read. It's because we don't write. So they write their own story. And they call it what? History. His own story, not your story. Didn't write. His story about you. History. Where is our story? Where is our story? And when you write it all, where did he put it? He lied on you about you, and he buried it in the library. It becomes library. See the trend?